trying to save up your energy for Bedlam?
No. No, I actually, with guys, and no, not like putting anything on this guy, but usually you see an unranked guy and you gotta be careful, because, I mean, like last week, I wrestled an unranked guy and got caught in a sticky situation, and I was sore the next day, and I don't know, man. So, coach always says, take things real serious, and some of these guys are scrappy, and they can, and they're not, and their ranking didn't have anything to do with it. It's just some guys are scrappy and they're wild and they like to roll around and do a lot of things, and it could hurt you. And it's too late in the season to put any, or to go out and risk putting on a full match and allowing this guy to have any time to do anything to you to hurt you as well. And so, really, it's just protecting yourself and taking things real serious. If there's an opportunity to pin it, I just want to take it.
That was actually something I was going to ask. What did you learn from last weekend? I mean, the fact that you were in a situation where you almost got pinned and you had to go to a sudden victory to get that win against an unranked wrestler.
Mm-hmm. It was a. It was just a bad match. I wasn't feeling very good that day, but I mean, you could drop a million excuses. It just wasn't my day, but I wanted to come back and make sure nothing like that ever happens, and to stay solid, really. I mean, you go out and if you mess around with these guys, they'll try to steal the match, and you don't want to give them that opportunity. So.
Obviously, you're not necessarily an Oklahoma kid,
yeah.
But what does Bedlam mean for you? Obviously, you spent at least 1 year in Oklahoma before coming to Oklahoma State.
I mean, I've heard stories, and I've heard all these matches, and I know some of the guys on the whole team, and it's just as much of the attitude that we need to bring to them like we brought to Iowa. It's personal. We don't need to beat these guys. We want to beat these guys, and it's not something that coaches like, oh, if you can, like, or like, this is a good opportunity for us, or anything like that. It's OU, we hate them, they hate us, we're going to battle it out, and we are definitely going to come out on top.
Coach Smith had a pretty extended conversation with you guys after last school. How do you guys think he kind of rallied around that, and how did everything just kind of come into fruition with today's duel?
Just taking things serious. I mean, you can't just float around with guys, and you look at you and I, and we've never wrestled them before in a duel. And we're first time ever wrestling them, and we don't really know what kind of team they are. And coaches only really knew that, and we kind of went out and tried to feel them out and didn't really take things serious and try to will ourselves to opportunities to win big and win hard matches, and kind of took the easy road out. I mean, me personally, I was on bottom, and I just was like, well, I can't get out, and I just laid there, and when I should have worked myself out of that position, but instead I settled for laying there and going into a sudden victory and possibly losing a match, and that's not the way that we need to be thinking. And so this week we amped up our training and amped up the way that we think and our mentality, and so it's been good. It's actually been a great week of workouts. We were all sitting there before and saying, man, we feel better today than we've felt all season long. Usually you feel worse because as the season goes on, you get more wear and tear, but we've been doing stadiums and just building our legs.
All right. Were you thinking the mustache?
No. No. If you go into overtime with an unranked guy, you can't have a mustache. So that's coach's philosophy.